and prepare for a lot of loud fan noises. Sounds like a motorboat.
It does sound like somebody's trying to start something up. So then, Jack, what have we got today? What is that horrendous noise in the background?
That is the fan of my JTAG's Xbox 360. It's a very loud boy, as you can hear.
I will take a photo of the loud boy.
But the main reason I bought this Xbox in is because I have a Christmas themes game on here that we didn't get. It was only released in Japan. What was reasonably locked to those consoles. So you need a Japanese or modded Xbox 360 to even play it.
So, I like that opening screen. What is that from?
I don't know if it's from a game or something, but yeah, it's a very old, outdated dashboard. I would just update to Aurora, but I don't want to risk breaking this thing. But yeah, this is the game in question right here. Deathsmiles 2X, Makai no Merry Christmas.
Nice one. So because it's got a Christmas tree on background, is it like Little Women?
Yeah, it's basically a Christmas themed shoot 'em up.
Oh wow. Oh, right, okay then. Christmas Eve.
It's all in Japanese, but I can basically summarise the whole thing. Basically, this girl named Windia finds another girl named Supe off the street on Christmas Eve.
It's sweet, isn't it? It looks really lovely. The drawing is absolutely gorgeous.
But then, oh no, she's evil and their caretaker is dead.
Oh my gosh, she brought an evil kid into the house. No!
But the point is she's not actually evil, she's being controlled by this lovely fella.
No.
The evil Satan Claus.
He's got great looking teeth for something that's evil, hasn't he?
He basically runs off with 5 musical notes that we have to get back from various bosses and even him.
I like the look of this, it's really cool.
We're gonna go with Deathsmiles 2X mode because it was redesigned for the Xbox 360, put in widescreen, voice acting and everything. So I guess if you just press start on your controller, it should hopefully let you. There we go.
Oh.
I call dibs on Windia Chan.
That's fine, I'll be evil kid.
well she's not technically evil, she's on our side now.
Right, okay then. So I love that organ music, by the way.
So level 1 is easy, not many projectiles, and level 2 and 3 just give us more of that, so whatever you're comfortable with will be fine enough.
I've got you. Can you recover me for that?
Maybe.
Whatever you feel confident, you know my skills, Jack. So if you feel like, yeah, let's go level 2.
Yeah.
Heroics low.
And we have infinite continues, so.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
I must say, it just looks really nice.
I love the Japanese language, even though I can't understand it, like, at all.
Just the way it's written and everything.
And away we go. A and B shoot left and right respectively. The triggers can also be used to shoot.
Alright, I can't kill you, can I?
No, Friendly fire is not on, thankfully. And we can also press Y to use bombs.
Oh.
If we ever find ourselves in a pinch.
Coming, it's chasing me now. Ah! Oh!
And you just got hit.
It's not got me in the big bag. What's going on? Oh, are these demon things? What's wrong?
Don't worry, I've got them all for you.
Oh, nice Christmas tree in the background. Oh, look! Big.
Slow down, city!
Oh, wow. This is cool.
Slow down in cave games is kind of a funny subject. Sometimes it's done during when there's a lot of bullets on the screen.
Yeah.
But in my opinion, for this mode, it's kind of done a little too much here.
Tinkerbell's after me again. Got my first Tinkerbell. Oh, no, I don't think so. So all these evil things, are these what this guy sent to us to get us? Is that what's happening?
I mean, for all we know, this could just be an everyday thing for them.
Is this Rudolph? What's going on here? Oh, evil Rudolph. Oh my god. I ain't got cool Rudolph, have I? Oh, I am? Oh my god, no!
She's called Lily, by the way. So not really an evil Rudolph.
We're gonna knock that red nose off your face. Welcome to the party, pal.
Yeah.
Oh, evil Santa. Oh, I wonder if you're still listening to this game. This is brilliant.
And that's the end of her.
Bye-bye. Oh, we want some up.
And now the notes scatter all across the land. In single player, this would have been just banter with whatever character you were and their familiar. So now we can go to fields B through E in whatever order we please.
Okay, I'll let you choose.
I think it's certainly best to go in alphabetical order for now.
Yeah.
Bit of due diligence. Oh, suicide bullet scotch, sorry about that.
Oh, flying.
Yeah, bombs are really good for when you're in a pinch and surrounded. By a lot of bullets, but you can't see yourself getting past.
So was this game only released on Xbox 360 or...?
Well, it was originally in Japanese arcades, but then it was ported to Xbox 360. And later this year, it's a compilation of that includes this, and the first Deathsmiles is coming to Xbox, PS4 and Switch.
Oh wow!
Which is a good thing. Oh!
Yeah, so if you enjoy this, look out for it.
Oh, you're dead. You're gonna have to press start.
Oh, right, okay. Player 2. There
was several playing it. Oh, I was just doing that one. Next boss, and it's a rock golem thing. I can pretty much dance around these things if I want.
Yeah, rock dog.
Take it! Thanks for the save.
How did I do something? I don't know what I did.
Yeah, that bomb just kind of saved me just then.
I just thought I'd press Y and press Y for a while. So I just thought I'd press it.
I don't know how well I would have done without it, but hey.
Cool, I'm glad I was useful for once.
I guess it's only fair I let you choose where we go next.
I think we're going to go for E. E for echo.
E.
Echo the dolphin.
The most memeable letter in the whole outfit.
One of my favourite games of all time. I can't play it on the first stage on it.
So it's worth noting that this level wasn't in the arcade version. This is one of the two levels that they brought in specifically for this mode.
That's cool. I'm loving this. There's not many Christmas games, and I think especially Christmas sugar games like this.
Yeah. I think for this reason, this is probably one of the more interesting Christmas games out there. Because, hey, only Japan can think of a concept as wacky as an evil Santa. And you're dead again. No one likes jellyfish. unless you're a naughty anime girl. Our next boss is some sort of spooder thing.
Ooh, I've got my finger out of spider.
He angy. That glorious intentional slowdown.
Yeah, I pressed Y again, I that out. Oh, where'd you come back?
And then the rest of its body came off.
Oh, it's like a lobby now. Oh my god. Get lost!
Kill it! Yeah, if everything explodes, it's dead.
Cool.
Yeah. Anyway, that's 2 of 5 notes that we've gathered so far.
Okay.
See
you then.
C.
For Charlie.
C for Charlie goes up the Tower of Doom and sadness. This is probably my favourite place for point hunting because I can just shoot these pillars all day long.
Where did these two girls get the superpowers from then?
To be fair, they don't really establish it very well, unless it's probably in the manuals or something. But these girls were. But these skills were all going to have something terrible happen to them, but then they were spirited away to this magical land where they became angels. About time I got hit by something, but didn't really get a full bar taken off me. Gotta admit, even though Lindia isn't the strongest character, she's basically been my main.
Yeah.
Kind of like how you may see the Ice Climbers as sort of a novelty character in Smash. I still love them just for that. And it's only fitting that this Tower of Doom would have a snake boss.
Wow, they're really well drawn. Heavy snake.
Heavy snake.
It's heavy name.
It's snake.
It's 70s.
I mean, to be fair, you were pretty much diving into it.
Yeah, well, oh, yeah. Yeah,
take that, you have a snake. Woohoo! And that leaves us with one place to go for now, Field D. Love the music here as well. Probably the last place I'd want to go on. Christmas, but hey. If these girls can handle it, anyone can. Power up! I should have probably turned suicide bullets off now that I think about it. When you think about it.
Really well composed, that's great. I'm glad to hear that they're making this,
and from what I hear, it's not going to be region locked.
That's cool. Oh, somebody's got the hand. Oh my god! Oh,
without life. It's all hands, I'm guessing. I think this should be the last one. Yep. Get all those out of the way.
This thing that follows me around, I thought it were a demon at first. I thought it was smart to kill. I was trying to kill it for ages. Then I realised who's got one, and I thought it must be.
Those are our familiars.
Oh, must be random.
To be honest, I have no idea what this thing is supposed to be. Some sort of Frankenstein's monster?
Oh,
That's like the best worst voice acting ever from this game. So 4 out of 5 notes. Where does that leave us? With a nice little break by the campfire.
Yeah, I can have a quick drink while it's doing that.
Here's where things get interesting. We can either go to Satan Causer's castle, or we can go to his carnival land for a bit of fun.
Oh, carnival land. Let's go to carnival land. Carnival land.
So, pick that controller back up, we'll go
yeah.
there.
Okay. Sorted.
It's sort of an extra stage. And, and needless to say, this also wasn't in the arcade version.
Oh, we'll have to shoot this big fat thing here. No. So this one in arcade. Wow. I like that they made some special things, but again, that's cool. They have some great games in Japan that are just exclusive, and I wish they sort of let us have him, you know. I wish they'd made him so we could
one.
It's really cool.
I mean, to be fair, there were a couple of cave games that we could play on foreign 360s, like the regular release of Escaluda, Mushihime-sama Futari.
Hmm. Cool. Oh, it looks like a monster out of this thing.
I think Dodonpachi Sidai Oju was in there as well.
Oh, wow.
I know to most people this probably looks like the Xbox 360 is struggling to run this, but no, the slowdown is just part of the game.
Wow, one mean jumbo looking animal. Thank you.
not many enemies coming up. Do you so much know a boss?
Oh, here we go. What's it gonna be? Oh! The thing's out of Five Nights at Freddy's. What's he got around his shoulders or something? What's he got there? It's a bit wrong. Oh! Mad Teddy and Mad Buddha.
Move! I flew right into that like an idiot. I know.
They just look like they were in love at the beginning. Oh look, it's defending. Defending rabbit. Wow. That's heroic.
I deserved... I should have got hit then. I was risking it all.
Oh, they just fizzled out at the end. That would come alive.
Anyway, now it's off to the castle.
All right, cool.
I mean, to be fair, she was being manipulated at all. So when you were thinking about an assault on this castle, were you thinking giant evil chess pieces?
Yeah, well, actually.
Apparently Japan does.
Well, it's for Harry Potter though, isn't it? So why not?
Stuff like this kind of makes you wish you were a fly on the wall listening onto this. Any ideas for Christmas themed enemies, giant chess pieces?
Yeah.
Maybe they're upside down. These two refuse to go down quite as easily. So yeah, pretty obvious mini boss. You can.
I know, it's in a sort of scream that I know I'm gonna like thinking I'm under you. On here. I was thinking I just got underneath you and then I
was
like, I hit scream and thought,
no,
I'm dead.
We still got more to go. One
must
climb.
Oh, wow.
With Cupid spawning out of nowhere, no less.
That's what you want in your life, isn't it? Evil, red-eyed Cupids. Just tell Da Vinci wanted them to work. Not with Da Vinci, really not.
Were they Da Vinci? I don't know.
No, you
And here's the big bad himself.
Oh. That means basically we're going to sort you out for good.
Yeah.
You're dead, man.
He's been a very naughty boy.
Fuck his tail.
Yeah, he's kind of nuts. Satan calls.
It's not something out of Futurama.
I don't know what I was doing then. That was like the dumbest idea I ever had. Behold his true form.
Oh, he's got big long fingernails. Yeah, scratch me back, mate.
That part I understood. Nonny.
What does that mean?
Basically just means what? This is strangely upbeat final boss music.
Always
done
just for
that. That was a lot faster than I expected it to be.
Oh no, it's still there. Is it dead? Oh, it's gone. Bye.
Back to the depths with you, Satan. And the last note then pops up.
Yeah. Woo!
So now we can just sit back and enjoy the finale.
Brilliant, isn't it?
The day Christmas was saved by anime.
That's brilliant. Oh, she's got no clothes on. What's going on? It's a kid's game.
Bold of you to assume that this is a kid's game. but yeah, the notes are like Dragon Balls. We can pretty much summon this goddess to bring up. Summon this goddess to bring our caretaker back.
Brilliant. That's what you want in your life. None of that running around a map, blowing on a flute to try and get things done, is it?
Yeah, it's a lot easier if you have like no musical knowledge whatsoever.
Yeah. And it's snowy. I want it to snow.
And this guy is now not dead.
I have a bad dream. Some crazy kid did not kill him.
And then you just have Casper in a Christmas tree and Suke dressed like a snowman.
So this is Deathsmiles 2, so was there a first one?
Yeah, there was a first one and we actually had it. Yeah, it actually came out over here for the Xbox 360, and I've got it on here.
Oh, that's interesting.
But I'll probably save that for another day, maybe Halloween.
Is that Christmas themed?
No, the first game is themed entirely around Halloween.
All right, cool. That's one for next year then.
So not too bad. We had ourselves a party and a little feast at the end.
Yeah, just like it should be at Christmas. That is a big lump of cheese. That cheese is bigger than turkey.
So yeah, Deathsmiles 2.
Brilliant. Japanese have such cool names, don't they?
Yeah. Why is Sakura mentioned in the cast? She doesn't even appear in this game.
And they were really good. I think the music was really cool.
So is it worth seeking out if you can find a Japanese or modded 360?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think there's a lot of really cool games that we sort of missed out on, and or probably didn't realise we could get. You know, I like it.
Yeah, because when you look at stuff like this, region locking the 360 was kind of a big mistake.
Yeah. I think region locking any console
which is why I'm glad that the current gen don't have it. Like Like, we have a North American cartridge of Super Mario Party. We can put that in our Switch and it'll run just fine.
Yeah, and clearly Japanese, the people that created this wanted us to play it because they used a fair bit of English in it as well. So, you know, I think it's been good. I enjoyed it.
But anyway, do I want to save my replay? Nah, not really.
But yeah, some nice little cards. Oh, cool. Nice one.
Why is the game saying I used to continue? I didn't die. So does that make it a 1cc on my end, or...?
I don't know. But look at your score tonight.
That's like... So... 335 million... Versus your 6 million, because each continue resets your score.
It resets it completely? That's bad, isn't it?
I see it as a good incentive for score hunters, at least.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, look at that. Good find, that giant
blanket. Good find. I've known about this for a good decade now.